Hey everybody, welcome back to Loading Screen.
Indeed.
This is Grand Spirit Tree Shield. Oh, okay. I guess we're doing this instead.
How did she get back here?
She actually does have a teleport item.
Oh, does she really?
Yeah, in fact, once we get a little bit farther into the game, she'll just give it to us.
Oh, okay.
Awesome. I should have enough faith to finally use the spell I want. There we go. So get rid of that, and I'll get rid of one of the heals. And yes. So this is what I've worked all game to get. Check it out. This is the Sunlight Blade spell.
Alright, that looks cool.
Yeah, super cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah, gives me a lightning buff, which scales with my faith to be really strong and face punchy.
Huh. Yeah, that is... I mean, that looks cooler than the Dark Sword.
Yeah. So... I'm going to try something. I need some souls as, like, startup capital. That's plenty. And then I think Malentia is the one who sells. Yes. Gonna get me this Caestus. And I'm going to teleport to someone you haven't seen in a while.
Huh. Pate.
McDuff. Oh. No, we've actually seen the last of Pate.
Like, oh, okay.
I fucked up something, and I didn't trigger their final encounter. And
all right.
I'm not going to go looking for it, because all you would have seen was me kill one of them.
Oh, it's him.
Yeah, McDuff. Oh, yeah. A.K.A. Duffman. Do I have? Yes, I have poison. So let's see if this work. If this still works, because if it does, it'll be hilarious.
All right.
Back to Majula.
Insolent armor?
Yeah, it's kind of a dick. You're like, hey armor, like protect me from this sword, and it's like, fuck you, Dad.
I wanna go protect the Justice League.
Yeah. Well god, why couldn't I be a power armor? Couldn't it be with Master Chief? Dad's like, in this game we play Marathon. I think that was the game's name? Marathon?
Was it?
The predecessor to Halo? Nobody cares. Anyway. So, in the tomb, I picked up this nifty little number. Here we go. The Crushed Eye Orb. Which, detects the guilty. Or, it looks for dishonorable miscreants.
Okay.
So, I'm gonna go visit my cleric buddy here. And, what do you know? Somebody's hiding something.
Huh, okay.
Why don't we see what that is?
Oh, you use it?
Yes.
Wait, what just happened? Like...
I'm invading her.
Oh, really? You're not doing very much damage.
No, but I'm poisoning her.
Alright, well, she's poisoned. Wait, what? What is this crap?
So, the thing with this bitch is that she is an incredibly annoying boss fight because she can heal herself. And she can also cast spells. Because, you know, she's a cleric. So, it's very hard to burst her down. Because if she gets away from you for a second, she'll start throwing lightning at you. And then while you're recovering from the lightning, she'll just cast healing spells on herself. So, the easiest way...
But you can just stunlock her?
Yes, essentially. I made myself a poisoned Caestus, and so I'm just poisoning her constantly. Look at how much health she has.
Yeah.
I'm just poisoning her constantly, and the swing from my fist weapon is fast enough that I can interrupt her casting.
Yeah, but it seems like you could just...
I fucked up. She got some of her health back.
Oh, okay.
You gotta get into a little rhythm here.
It seems like you could just interrupt her with anything, like...
No, the speed isn't fast enough on your other stuff.
Oh, so like a sword wouldn't work?
Because different weapons kind of have different stamina costs.
Oh, I see. I see.
Yeah, the Caestus' stamina cost is low enough that even if you go to zero stamina, you'll recover enough pretty quickly that you can just, you know, go back to swinging. So you really just have to, like, swing and then wait a beat.
Yeah,
and swing.
A second.
Yeah, see. When she got it, she got enough time to get a heal off because I mashed it a little too much, and I wrecked the rhythm. So yeah, we're just gonna keep doing this.
Okay, she's almost dead.
She's almost dead. Almost there. There we go.
Oh wow!
Ta-da! And I got all her special chime and her outfit if I wanted to wear it.
Huh.
Yay.
So like why did you have to invade her? Why couldn't you just kill her like normally?
You could, but that wouldn't count as completing the quest, and I mean
I see.
Just funsies. Here's the other fun thing we got from that fight. I got the little device that activates the room.
Oh, cool. So now you don't have to pay her dumb face.
I mean, there's no reason to ever go back there after you do it the one time.
Oh, okay.
But it's nifty. Oh, I never showed you. I also got this way back when.
The
twin blade.
That looks awesome.
It is, and it's insanely broken. It does tons of damage, and this little combo does, like, will, like, stunlock people like crazy.
Dude, that's amazing.
Yeah, it's quite cool. Wait, here it is. See, all those are a hit, every single one.
Oh, wow. Wait, is it only two hits?
No, it counts
no,
as
no,
a
No, I mean
more.
In the combo.
Oh, yeah.
So it's that one, and then right. That one.
And it just recycles
that. Oh, the first one, okay.
And then you can also do the spin to win.
Oh, that is probably the coolest weapon.
It is, it's quite cool. If I had extra... I might actually trick it out. I think I actually can go and buy stuff to trick it out. Let me go check on that. But yeah, that was a fun little side trick I could do. Because we're not going to be doing another full dungeon this week. I don't think I'll have time. Instead, we're going to go wrap up some unfinished business with a certain person.
Oh, it's...
Here we go. So after you get the King's Ring, that triggers a few different little things. The first is one of the most important ones is that Cloanne here activates the rest of her inventory, one of the most important things is that it lets you can buy some really rare materials in limited quantities from her.
Huh.
One of the most important the most important of which really is these Titanite chunks. Oh, I have 8. Neat. I've got a lot. I think you need, like, 12 to fully upgrade something?
Huh.
Visit me.
And, I should actually hold off on the blade for the moment. I might want to use Evelyn. Anyway, let's go back to plot. So, we're gonna go all the way back to the Forest of the Fallen Giants.
Okay.
This is where the game gets a little, like, hard to follow. Or this is where it gets hard, like, to figure out where the hell you're going next.
Okay.
Because, I mean, you don't have to do this part immediately, but you do have to do it at some point. And so you're probably not going to be able to infer... Oh, wait, no, I can't do this yet. Okay. Actually, I might as well at least do this one a little bit. I forgot there's something I'm missing. But...
Yeah, just like in general.
Remember these guys? Oh man, so hard.
Like in general, I feel like this is really a lot longer if you, you know, obviously if you don't know where you're going, but yeah. Like.
So these doors say produce the symbol of the king.
Oh.
That is the King's Ring.
They're like those black doors in Chrono Trigger.
Yeah. And as a fun aside, the King's Ring will also increase your fire damage by like 5% or so.
Oh.
So it's nifty if you're a pyromancer. But yeah, I figured while I was here, I might as well activate this bonfire so I can get back here quickly later on.
So I'm waiting for you to hit something with your sunlight blade.
Oh, I'm going to be doing a lot of that.
Okay. Actually, oh, the door's closing on you.
Yeah, but I can just teleport back here anytime I want.
Oh, okay.
Speaking of which, I think I got enough speed that I can just switch back to the Hexer Hood. So let me test this really quick. Yeah, it's still fire pretty fast. And the Hexer Hood gives me +1 to all my spells.
Oh.
So I have, like, I'm going to have a few extra Dark Orbs. Okay, so now we are going back to Shade Woods.
So, episode 469 of Naruto Shippuden has revealed Kakashi's face.
Oh man, is it like a face?
It's it's actually funny because he's got, like...
Wait, isn't Naruto over?
Ending?
I thought Naruto, like, actually ended. Like, he, like, married Hinata or something and...
Manga, though, right?
Oh, right, the anime.
This is in the anime.
I forgot anime is different from manga.
Oh, God.
Ah, I thought I could dodge that.
I forgot that he pulled me.
Yeah. Let me see if I can sunlight blade him.
Oh, yeah.
I just need to back off a bit.
So awesome.
Yeah, super cool looking. And I need to get a heal going. He chases you quite far.
Sweet.
Yes. Sunlight Blade is the coolest weapon buff by far, and it pisses me off that it takes so long to get in this game. Because, like, Lightning Sword is the best sword of all swords. Fiat.
But yeah, it's actually a really, like, derpy face. And you can see why he covered it.
Do they ever show his face in the manga, you know?
I don't know. I mean, I assume that's why people...
Wait, didn't he die?
No.
I thought Kakashi died.
No, Guy died.
But I mean, I could have... I remember back when I went to visit Lauren in Japan, she was, like, really sad because Kakashi had died.
Huh. Well, maybe they're not there in the anime yet.
Did he, like, die and then come... Well, this was years ago. This was, like, 7 years ago. So, like, did they just, like, fake you out? Or did they, like, bring him back to life? Or what the hell happened there? I don't care. I'm just... I was just wondering if you could clear that up.
No, I don't, I haven't actually kept up with Naruto, but...
Well, maybe you should, Evan. I ask questions about stuff, and you can't deliver them. What good are you to me?
Hold on, I'm trying to find...
No good, that's what. No good.
Here, look at his derp face.
Hey, hang on.
Alright.
Wow, yeah. Like, that is somebody who is not meant to have a face.
Yeah.
So remember our buddy Luca Teal?
I like Luca Teal.
Well, this is the end of her quest.
Who are you? Oh, no, forgive me. I know you. Yes, of course. How goes your journey? I know not what you seek in this.
Oh, did she get amnesia?
I pray for
you. You lose your identity as you hollow.
Oh, okay.
Please take these.
Oh man, Luca Teal's clothes are cool.
That's the last we'll ever see of Luca Teal.
Alright, well, that's sad.
She just hollows, presumably.
Yeah. Well, give her the souls. Or well, give her a human effigy.
Well, that's what's ironic. She actually gave us a human effigy. See, I got her.
Oh.
I got her outfit.
That actually looks really cool.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to wear this for the rest of the episode in honor of our dead buddy.
Alright. We've got 72 Dark Orbs now.
Yes, because of the hat. Otherwise, I'd be wearing her hat, because it's a cool hat. Ah, shit, I messed up.
Monkeys? Wait.
These little dudes will turn you to stone, which will insta-kill you if it fully goes up.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's really bad. It's like what the basilisks do. But more annoying, because they're like...
But you're holding all those fragrant branches of yore.
Yeah, but you can't use it on yourself. That'd be silly.
Just, like, eat a piece.
I thought
he was alive. Yeah.
I thought so too, yeah. Oh, look at all these dead bodies. I'm sure there's nothing here at all. Yeah, this one's for Lucatiel. Oh, shit!
Oh, good! Whoa!
I've never seen him... Like, usually they go into their full, standing up animation. Okay. Well, right. That was for you, buddy.
We did it, Lucatiel.
Man, I ruined what could have been a cool moment. This is all your fault, Tim. You should have warned me.
Alright. Oh, it's the monkeys are back, though.
Yeah, but it's cool. So, we're gonna do it this way. The manly way. The 72 dark orbs way.
Like, what I don't get is where do those legs come from? Like, the arms are clearly from the inside, but the legs just spring, just, like, generate out of thin air.
They come from a land down under.
And what? Oh, that's a guy.
Yes. Just a guy. Alright. And then I believe over here there's a thing. Yes, there's a thing. Fire seed. I haven't paid much attention to these, but I can use them to upgrade my pyromancy flame that I never use.
Duh.
And then I can also get this radiant life gem here. And now we're going to see the last little tiny bit of Lugatiel's side quest.
Oh hey, Kane was from 4, right? Final Fantasy?
Yes.
Oh, he's in Dissidia now.
He's been in Dissidia.
Oh, okay.
This is Ezlatiel. This is Lugatiel's brother.
All right.
Her whole reason she went on her journey was she was looking for her brother, who,
Who's got a wagon that shakes?
No, the wagon is actually, like, a weird, completely random reference to, Demon Souls.
Oh.
Where there were a bunch of those just, like, kind of there to scare you, and I think there were one or two where, like, stuff would actually jump out.
Huh.
If you can... farther into the dungeon, there are more of those, like, hippo guys, and you can trick them into breaking things.
Okay.
And if you have them break the thing, I believe there's a basilisk inside. But it will not come out of its own volition. What does it say? Man. I know, right?
Like.
So here's a fun thing. Oh, look at that skeleton. Do-do-do-do-do.
Alright, that's not gonna come to life or anything, yeah.
I like it when skeletons look like things.
Yeah.
Is that way you can, like, tell what the thing... I forgot how that goes.
Yeah, you can tell what the thing was before it became a skeleton?
Yeah, yeah. You said that in a weird way, but I agree with you.
Yeah.
I don't know what's... The skeleton is supposed to come to life.
Is it really?
Yeah.
The thing is huge, though. You can't fight that.
Well, you don't fight it.
Oh.
I'm not triggering this properly. Like, you're supposed... Like, it's a death trap. If you stay in the room, it just pounces on you and you die. But it's been triggered, like forever after that.
Huh.
So you don't have to worry about it anymore. So all you do is just walk out of the room when it's gonna pounce, and you're fine.
But it's not.
Oh, look at these.
Pull back. What? Why?
These are not placed by players.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And then there's this thing.
What?
So I'm a hollow, so I should be able to go and check this
out. Wait, so was that a lever there at the end of that?
That was a lever. And here's the reason why they're telling you to pull back. Oh, what's this?
What? Try hollow, but... Okay. Murder.
Why not?
Yes, I see how you see, like that guy was murdering too. It's sometimes people just murder a little.
So this guy will only appear if you're hollowed. He's some crazy murdering ghost guy.
Okay.
Who's locked in here. If you pull the lever, he escapes. And then he just invades you, like, 3 or 4 times.
Oh.
But if you come here when you're not hollowed, I believe it'll update dynamically.
I haven't said anything strange. Huh?
That's his host.
Oh.
Only hollows can talk to the actual guy.
Oh, okay. Do not
attempt to help me. Just... See?
Oh, wow.
So basically he gives us a little series of murder quests. You can either just straight up kill the person he tells you to kill, or you can acquire the item that he asks you to bring back an item as proof that you killed them, and every item can be acquired non-lethally.
Okay.
So for example, right now he told us to go kill Gilligan and bring back his ladder miniature. The ladder miniature is
treasure goblin.
That's not a treasure goblin.
Oh, what?
It'll actually explode.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah, it's a red one.
Okay.
That's how you know it's gonna explode. But, yeah, the ladder miniature you can actually just straight up buy. I think I might have bought it.
Huh.
Or maybe not. But, yeah. I don't know if I'll go around and do them. You get a really good pyro spell from completing all of his quests, but, yeah, it's really worth it.
You're not doing
that. Here's something really cool. Check this out.
Oh, hey.
Yeah.
Oh, he's gonna get out.
He is. I really like this. It's, like, freaky as fuck. Because most players are just going to walk to the end because there's a glowy over there.
Yeah.
And they're going to see all these dudes pounding on the mirrors and be like, what the...
What, does every mirror contain a phantom?
Not all of them. I think like 2 of them do. 3 of them.
But how did that guy get like halfway in?
I don't know. All your problems really are solved by 72 Dark Orbs.
Yeah.
I got 41 left.
I guess those ones are...
I could have even more if I put on that ring.
Oh, there's one. I'm surprised that the freaking shrapnel doesn't, like, hurt you.
Yeah, you'd think, right? You'd think that's like an easy thing, an easy fuck you for the player.
Yeah, like that. It seems like the kind of things a Souls game would do.
There's no illusion here. Yeah, I figured it's just someone being a dick.
Oh, okay. Maybe it's behind the chest?
No, I'm like 99% sure there's nothing here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, so you see the chest and you go, ooh, chest! And then shit happens. Is that a... Oh, neat. It's loot. It's loot.
Oh, cool. It's the tank.
Yeah. I don't know why he's here.
You didn't summon?
I didn't summon him. He's not good for actual, like, fighting.
Oh.
He just, like, he dual wields shield, so he just pulls aggro from you. Oh, right. That's why they give you the
thing. Oh, the branch, yeah.
Yeah. In the PS3 version, there is a side path you could take to get around him, I believe.
Oh, okay.
But, yeah, you just got a fragrant branch of yore. And you think he'd be grateful that you, What the, he fell on me?
Yeah.
I've never seen that happen.
You think all of these petrified beings would be grateful?
Well, the hollows I could see, because the hollows are insane.
Yeah, I mean, but those lion guys...
The lion guys and these ogre guys are just malicious assholes.
Yeah.
So, I guess what I'm saying is fuck animals in general. Like, fuck those guys. Fucking Zootopia, more like Pootopia.
I did see that movie.
I actually really liked Zootopia.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
The sloths at the DMV are so fucking funny.
Oh, yeah.
That was the best part. And look, it's another one of these things.
Oh, wow. Wait, that one's big.
I fought a big one before. I think I fought, like, two of them.
Huh.
You just have a really shitty memory for stuff we did, like, a year ago.
So, wait, he can't, like, get out of that?
If I get too close, he'll break out. But, you know, 72 Dark Orbs.
Yeah.
Fun fact, the second... Each of the point of the DLCs is to go and acquire the crowns of the other kings in this land.
Okay.
And each of them has a special ability. Generally just like a stat boost of some kind. But the crown of the Iron King, the second release DLC, make it so that every couple of minutes you just recover like a chunk of your spells.
Oh wow.
Yeah, so if you just equip like a repair spell and a heal spell, then you can pretty much just go indefinitely without ever seeing a bonfire again.
Huh.
It's pretty great.
Or, yeah, like, ran out of dark orbs, like, go make a sandwich.
Yeah.
Come back.
And if you get all the, if you get all the crowns and complete the DLC, then you get the ultimate benefit, which is, as long as you're wearing a crown, you will never go hollow.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you always retain your human form. Of course, the downside is that once you've achieved that, there's nothing left to do. Because there's no... I mean, you might still... I mean, you could just put off the final boss of this game. Of the main game.
Right.
But, I mean, yeah. It's like you have, like, nothing left to do. Really? So. And it does not carry over into... The blessing does not carry over into DLC.
Lame.
Yeah. Or into... Blessing does not carry over into New Game Plus, is what I was trying to say. But, yeah. Where is... This is completely useless, but I like to do it for convenience.
Oh, there wow. That's awesome.
And there's a mimic up there. I forget how you knock them down. Also, these guys are hiding behind paintings. These guys are actually quite resilient, and they will fuck you up if they actually hit you. But they're important because they're one of the only ways you can farm Petrified Dragon Bone.
Oh, okay.
Which is what you use to upgrade boss weapons. And is one of the reasons why I haven't actually used any boss weapons.
What's in the cage, like, above you right now?
There is just the mimic, I think.
There's a mimic, and then there's something else, and then there's an ogre. What is that? Oh, it's a giant one of those.
Yeah, it's one of those giant bugs. I think this guy falls down.
Really?
I thought he did. There's definitely something you can do to make him fall down. Oh, I think he just breaks himself out after a while.
Oh, okay.
Who's making the noise? Oh, look, there's a basilisk up there.
Huh.
Oh, it's that thing. Okay.
Oh, okay.
That's one of those abominations I poisoned to death in the sewer.
If you break those, do you get poisoned?
No.
They're glowing green.
Yeah, I know.
Was there some behind a bookcase up there?
Not there, but here's a dick move.
Whoa.
That's your bonfire for the dungeon.
They gotta stop hiding these behind freaking secret doors.
I know!
So are you like right at a boss? Because we're at time.
Oh, yeah, we're right at a boss. So I'm going to...
Kill it.
You want me to kill the boss?
Yeah.
Alright. I just wanted to leave a like bonfire here message.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Here we go.
Well, There's no here? There's only a head?
Yeah, there's only a head.
Oh, lame.
There you go. Yeah, I should be able
Wait,
to...
Wait, turn to your left? It looks like behind that bookcase. I thought I saw something glow.
Oh, there is.
Oh, cool.
A Pharaoh Lockstone, which, I think I just used the last, like, one. Or I think I just activated the last Lockstone mechanism.
Oh, okay.
Oh, right. I think I might have to... Do you mind going a couple minutes over?
Yeah, no, it's cool.
Because I believe the key is down here, and I've got to do this dumb shit. I have to take off all my clothes.
Okay.
So, this yellow stuff here is...
Equipment killer?
Yeah, it's corrosive. So you're supposed... They want to lure you in, and they're like, now your equipment's all broken, and you gotta fight these dogs. And you're like, shit, well, that sucks.
Yeah.
I don't want to fight dogs. And also, you broke my equipment. And especially bad if you're wearing the third dragon ring like I am, because that has insanely low durability.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Also, there are these spike walls that actually hurt you if you touch them.
Oh, man. Okay.
It's dumb. But because I know what's what, they can't touch me. I thought the key was in here.
Huh.
Did I get the key? I gotta put all my clothes again. Where is the hat? There it is. Hat, and Varam, and Lion Mage cuffs, and I forget which pants I was wearing. I think I was wearing Hexer's pants. There we go. Yeah, I really hate these little things that make you take off your shit.
Yeah. Like, what's the point?
Well, I mean, the point is to fuck you over.
Well, yeah.
But if you know what's what, then it's just an annoying, like, tedious exercise. There's my short bow. I need my shield. There's my shield. And I gotta equip the staff. And I need to equip the rings. I'm almost done with the equipment. There we go. Second dragon's ring, that's what I'm wearing. And then, what was my other ring?
It wasn't the king ring, right?
It wasn't the king ring. I had revelation and, Claranthi ring. That was it, the stamina ring.
Oh, okay.
I think I might just have to go the end of the hallway. There's a second door, I think. Oh, I'll find out right now. So, did I get the key? I did not get the key. Okay. I forgot how to do this.
Oh, can you...
You can also trick the ogres into breaking down this wall, and there's like...
Are those petrified dudes?
They are petrified dudes, because there are basilisks in here.
Oh, but you don't get anything for freeing them?
No. You can't free them. They're like, they're too broken up.
Okay.
They're all chipped and shit.
Oh, no sunlight blade.
There we go. I could have sworn they're... They might just move the key, because this happens.
Oh, alright.
Shit.
Whoa! Ugh. Okay, I guess he can't fit through that one.
No. Oh, no!
Oh, what the?
I don't remember if they changed that or not. I think I can get in through this door. No, that's locked too. How do I get in there? Where'd they move the key?
Okay, now he's stuck.
No, he's gonna get around.
Oh, okay. Oh,
oh shit, he freed the basilisk. You know what's the real dick move?
Huh.
There's another ogre behind that door in front of me.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So if you're like, shit, I don't want to fight the ogre, and you try to, like, run away, like, the other ogre, like, breaks down that door. Fucking ogres. Thankfully, ogres are no match for 72 black orcs.
No, they're not. Well, maybe they changed the ogre.
See behind this one? There it is. I actually jumped a little.
Freaking, okay, but how is he gonna... Oh, that door is just huge.
Yeah. I'm just gonna, like, lure him out a bit and go behind him. Ah, shit, I didn't roll far enough.
No, okay, you're good.
There we go. Alright, I'll have to look up where they moved that key, but, boss fight.
Wait, you suddenly came out into sunlight and are very high up.
Because we climbed up.
Yeah, but okay.
So here's the guardian dragon, who is not a dragon.
He's not?
No, he's a worm.
Oh. Oh, because he doesn't have the forearms.
Yeah.
He's got the arm wings.
He's actually really easy if you have a strong bow or crossbow, but I haven't bothered to upgrade mine. The main problem is that when he flies up, he's out of dark orb range.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I just have to wait for him to be on the ground, which isn't so good. Like all dragons, he's also insanely weak to lightning, which is handy. Also, he does this, and I can't reach him when he's up there.
Oh, I see. Just...
Oh yeah, I forgot. I have to, like, run to the end of the room. But everything's weak to Dark Orb.
Yeah.
72 Dark Orb, specifically.
Dude, like, the...
Yeah, I thought I got
splash,
all the way.
The splash radius on that.
Really close to killing him. Oh no!
Poof.
I rolled right into it. Got him.
Hey.
There's another one that people summon for all the time, and I don't know. Like, he's not super hard to beat. So, I'll just mosey on to the next bonfire, and I'll just let you see the really, really cool scenery.
Yeah, like, this is weird. It's like...
Well, no, we've been ascending Elida's Keep.
Yeah, but it's just weird to, like, have been in, like, a dank, you know, castle for so long.
And because we've been going up and up and up.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's cool.
Elida was a brilliant scientist, much like Goku's dad, Bardock, who was experimenting on dragons and homunculi in an attempt to defeat the curse.
Ah.
So it's implied that most of these dragons are artificial, or that all the dragons you fight here are artificial, that he made them, or something. So we go way
yeah, what the hell?
Up into the sky. Still going.
Okay, light.
Something energizer. Sure,
man, that would be the worst elevator to wait for if you pulled that lever.
Yeah.
What is this now?
Yeah, I actually don't remember that part, but now we're in the dragon airy.
Wait, is part of these structures, like, made of chalk or whatever this was?
No, these are all supposed to be rocks. I think the textures didn't load properly.
Okay. Seek lust?
The aged feather allows us to teleport to any bonfire as many times as we want.
Oh, good.
And Ash doesn't say anything. I'm going to use the bonfire really quick to see if that resets these textures.
Yeah, that looks like...
Because that hallway looked cool as shit, but I was like, I don't remember this. And
yeah,
it's not supposed to look this way.
At first I was like, okay, this mountaintop is where, you know, we mine the glowing white stones. And they built that one hallway out of it. You know, but like...
Okay, yeah.
Oh, so... perfect. All right. Oh no, part of them didn't load. Oh no, that's
no. That actually is how it looks. But yeah, so I just want you to see the view properly.
Wow, that was weird. And like the castle in the distance didn't load either.
Yeah. Okay, here we go.
This is
what it actually looks like.
Alright.
And also, this is the hallway.
Oh man, it looks so much less impressive now.
I know! The glowing white hallway was so cool.
I was like, okay, have we ascended to heaven?
Yeah, I was like, how do I not remember this? This is fucking cool. And yeah, it's just the textures.
Okay.
Alright, so...
Yeah.
Next time we'll tackle the Dragon Aerie and the Dragon Shrine.
Alright, and we'll see you guys.